Okay, so I created a wine lingo sheet, which I mentioned in one of the previous chapters, and I thought it would be a good idea to review the sheet with you, so to go through all of the terms. If you don't feel like going through all of the terms with me reading them to you, don't worry. You have this in your resources section, so you can print it out, have it with you handy, but I think it is important for me to at least go through them one time and then have you print it and go through the course with that sheet by you. Okay, so wine lingo sheet. I divided it in several sections to make it a little bit easier for you. We are going to start with the wine handling section. The term appellation. Appellation is a legally defined and protected geographical indication used to identify where the grapes of a wine were grown. Blend. Blend refers to the grape varieties used to produce a specific wine. Chaptalization. This is the process of adding sugar to unfermented grape must. Grape must is juice and pomace, which has the skins and the seeds in it. This process, chaptalization, is done to increase the alcohol level since the sugar is converted to alcohol during fermentation. Decanting. It is a process that allows a wine to breathe by adding oxygen. This allows the aromas to open up and the flavors to soften. It's a common practice in wines that have been aging for years in the bottle. Fermentation. This is the process in which the yeast convert the sugar of the grapes into alcohol. Fining. This is the process of removing unwanted material from the wine prior to bottling. Lees. These are dead yeast cells, and they are usually found at the bottom of a vat of a wine after fermentation. Now, some wines are aged on their lees, and this is called surlis. And this is done to add a toasty, more complex finish to the wine. Maceration. This is the process of leaving the grape juice in contact with the skins and seeds so that the juice can extract more tannins and flavor. Natural wine. This is a wine production that revolves around organic or biodynamic farming. In the winemaking process, there is minimal intervention, no fining, no chaptalization, and in many cases, no sulfites, or very little. Noble rot. This is a specific type of fungus that causes grapes to partially shrivel, concentrating their sugar content. Noble rot infection produces some of the highest quality disturbed wines in the world. Pip, that's the grape seeds. Phylloxera. So this is an insect that was responsible for almost destroying all of European vineyards in the late 1800s. It was discovered though that American root was resistant to phylloxera. And as a solution, European roots were grafted with American roots. Sulfites. Sulfites are a food preservative widely used in winemaking, and it is used in low quantities. It's a chemical compound that occurs naturally, but can also be produced in the lab. Terroir. Terroir refers to all the factors that contribute to the characteristics of a wine. This includes the location, altitude, soil, and so on. Varietal. This refers to the different varieties of grapes that exist. For example, Pinot Noir, Chardonnay, Cabernet Sauvignon, etc. These are all varietals. Vinification. This is another word for winemaking. Vintage. This is the year in which the grapes were harvested. Now let's look at all the terms that fall under the category of taste. Acidity. This refers to that crisp and refreshing taste that you have when you drink a wine. And it is generally more associated with white wines, but red wines also have that freshness. It's the acid, it's what makes you salivate. Astringency. This is what makes your lips pucker and your mouth pucker. That's the astringency in a wine. Balance is simply when a wine is smooth and harmonious, and not one flavor sticks out amongst the rest. So different flavors should balance each other. For example, acid should balance against sweetness. Body. When you hear the word body referring to a wine, it's talking about the weight of the wine in your mouth. how thin or thick does the wine feel? Think of it as the difference between skim milk or whole milk, that kind of feeling, bright. When you hear that wine is bright, it's not referring to the color, it's referring to how the wine tastes in your mouth. The higher the acidity, the brighter the wine will feel. Corked. It means the wine has been affected by TCA, and this is a natural compound that at higher levels, it adds a musty flavor to the wines. The wines that contain TCA are described as either being corked or having corkiness. Earthy. This is used to describe flavors such as soil, wet grass, barn, and so on. And these flavors are typically found in red wines. So dirt is a good thing. Finish. This can also be referred to as the aftertaste a wine leaves in your mouth. The better quality wines tend to have a longer finish that is rich, complex, and flavorful. Fruit forward. These are wines that leave a more fruity taste on your palate. Fortified. This is a style of wine where extra alcohol is added in the form of a spirit. Table wines are typically between 10 and 15% alcohol. Fortified wines are typically 15 to 22% alcohol. So, sherry, Madeira, port, these are all examples of fortified wine. Jammy. This is a term used to describe red wines with a cooked fruit flavor. Minerality. This is similar to a wine's earthiness. This is a strong minerality taste of the earth. Minerality typically refers to the flavor of stones. So think of earthiness as dirt and minerality as stones. Oaky. This has to do with the aromas and flavors of a wine left by the oak barrels in which the wine was stored and aged. Oxidize. This is a wine that has been overexposed to oxygen. Some of the side effects are this is the wine will lose color, flavor, and it can become a little bit brownish with pigments of bitterness. Palate. This describes the flavors and complexities of wine on your tongue and within your mouth. Residual sugar. This is leftover sugar remaining in the wine after fermentation stops. Structure. The more structure a wine has, the more layers of flavors you will taste. It is a way to describe the relationship between the acid, tannin, and alcohol in a wine. That is structure. Tannins. Tannins are a biomolecule found in leaves, buds, seeds, roots, and stems. Tannins add structure to the wine's taste. They are primarily found in red wine as the juice spends more time in contact with all of these elements, including the skin, which is a huge one. It is what makes one pucker at the bitterness of a wine. Now let's look at all the terms that fall under the category sight. Legs. When a wine is swirled, it leaves behind drops that slide down the sides of a wine glass, and this is due to the evaporation process. Those droplets are referred to as legs or tears. Sediment. These are solid particles that settle at the bottom of a bottle of wine. This is not a flaw, it's just a sign of a wine that was not filtered or fined before bottling. Now let's look at the categories under smell. Aroma. This refers to the overall smell of the wine. The aromas come naturally from the grape or vinification process. The aromas are not added to a wine. So when you hear, this wine smells like chocolate, this wine smells like pepper, nobody physically added pepper or chocolate to the wine. These are characteristics that the grape itself develops. Bouquet, another way of expressing the aroma or smell of a wine. Okay, I know these were a lot of terms, and that's why I highly, highly encourage you to print the wine lingo sheet, have it by your side, use it as a reference, and I think it will be very helpful. I think it will come in very handy.